The last video I showed you how to cut the background with magic wand tool. If you have watched it, if you haven't watched it, go back and watch it. But anyhow, I'm going to do that again very quickly, and then after that we're going to place an image behind this behind the face. So what I'm going to do is going to open the picture that I want to cut the background like I did last time. So gonna open and go here, and then so now I have it here, and I'm going to double click open it, and then it opens. So you double click on the layer itself. Let me show you closely here. Well, you double click in this one. If it is locked, if you see that lock, you double click it, or you just press the lock and then it will open. So what you do is you go grab the magic wand tool, which is here, and just grab it. What it does is, I forgot to mention last time, that it selects the one color. If there is one color, and it's gonna select it. So here we have almost blue everything. So you just select these areas. Of course, you can always make the tolerance bigger. So I give it 30, and let's go back. Oops. Okay. So select back everywhere, and once everything is selected, you see, and I showed you how to get it smooth. So you go to back image, no, actually select, modify, and then a smooth. That gives a smooth image, smooth edges as well. So Command X or Control X in Windows, and or you can go to edit and just cut it. By now I think you understand that. And then what I did was I made a new layer to put for the background. So you can just create a new layer right here that creates a new layer. If you want to name it, you can name it, but it's not important for now. So I just leave it as it is. And what you can do is, you, if you want to fill the background in that layer, you press, you hit the Control Space on Windows, and on Mac it's Command Space, and then you have the color of the background, which is here. So you can always change it if you want this color. That's the background color, and then that's the for it. And so what I'm going to do is drag this file underneath that one. So now you have a very solid background behind. But what if you want to place another image behind it? So it's very easy. You just go to get your picture or image. So I have it here. I'm going to put this mountains. If it's not scaled enough, you can always just drag it like this, you know, just to fit the background. That's the scale. And yeah, there you go. There you have it. Just enter, and then it's done. If you want to remove this image anywhere, you can do it always, of course. Just get it where you want it. And you can always turn off the layer by here. And if you save it like this, and then you will see it with the solid background. So I turn it on back. You can keep that there or not, or you can delete it. So, and you can put as much as images you want. So if you want to delete this one and you want to change the color for this one, you can just double click in this one and then you get the layer style. And from here you can change, of course, you can go to gradient if you want it, you know, you can have it gradient, or you can choose the gradients here, the blue, something like that, or like this, however you like it. That looks like Gaddafi's background, but anyhow. Oh, this is nice, actually. But this is transparent, so it sees the layer underneath that you have already, which is blue. So it will, yeah. This one. Well, I really like this one, so I keep it like that. And you can always, yeah, change. So you click, and then you can always change the person, of course. If you want to change the color or something, you know, you can always play with it. You can give a gradient face for this one. So, you know, if you lower opacity, oh no, doesn't work. What if I give it multiply? No, it's not. Anyhow, so that's how you change the background, and you can place another image behind the background. All you have to do is to play with these layers. So example, if I put this layer underneath here, and then I put this one here, now it's gone because this layer is above. So all you have to know is how to work with these layers, and it's very easy. So you can put this one underneath, works. You put this one, and because it was close, it was not visible, so that's why you didn't see it. So if I put this one underneath, it's gone. So you can put million images behind this background, and it's very easy to change it. So if you do learn something from this tutorial, please subscribe, and it's gonna, I need a lot of subscriber, of course, because I'm a beginner, so it will really help me to, if you leave comment on my channel, or you subscribe, or like my video, and things like that, it's gonna really help my channel, if you're willing to support. So I hope you learned something from this part two, and I'm gonna make more tutorials, and the next tutorial will be on how to use Liquify tool in Photoshop CS.